Good morning, students. Let's get back to our chapter 8, Framing of Constitution and its Features. The other day we studied from page number 56. I had given you the meaning of the Constitution, its importance, as well as how many days it took, which members were involved in that, and so on. We studied in the first lecture. Today, as I had told you to read and come, and that was about preamble. The other day I had told you to see, to read about preamble. So let's get back to our classes. What is a preamble, and why and what importance does it have in the Constitution? Be with me, students. Keep your pencils in your hand. What is preamble? Now, preamble is the core and important part of Constitution. Make bracket to that. Preamble is the core and important part of Constitution. Indian Constitution begins with preamble. The words written in the preamble highlight the soul of the Constitution. See, students, the powerful statement, preamble is the core and important part of Constitution. And so, students, the next sentence is that Indian Constitution begins with preamble. Now, what is that preamble? The picture is given over here. Preamble, the full page is shown how it is given in your book. Now, most of your books, your textbooks also have the first page, not the very first, but your textbook also begins with the preamble, some of the textbooks. And why? So the students, you get to know what is the preamble and why is it important. Then, the words written in the preamble highlight the soul of the Constitution. Highlight the soul of the Constitution. That important it is. And what are the words written? See, the words inscribed in the preamble are given below. They are over here. Students, just now I will read this for you. And we are going to study in detail. On the next page, on the page number 58, it's given in detail. Now, let's see what is given there. What is preamble? Now, Constitution of India. Look here. Constitution of India and the preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and to secure to all its citizens. These words, which are in block letters, in capital letters, they are very important. How does it begin? We, the people of India, not any other people, not from America, not from Africa, but we, the Indians, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute into India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and to secure to all its citizens. What do we want to secure? Justice. And what type of justice? Social, economic, and political justice. Liberty of what? Liberty of thoughts, expression, belief, faith, and worship. We do not force anyone to believe in one God, or believe in the worship only that particular God. But we give the freedom of expression, what you feel, what you think. Okay? Equality of what? In which way? Of status and of opportunity. And to promote among them all, that is fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, underline this, which we have seen this, very important, over here also, just see here, when the constitution was framed. So 26 November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact, and give it to ourselves this constitution. Okay, now just in short, let's pay attention. We saw the words over here: sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic, republic. What does it mean? And I told you we are going to see it in detail. But in short, what is the meaning of sovereign? A person who has a supreme power or authority is said to be sovereign. Okay? And then, what is a socialist? Okay? A political or economic theory of social organization which advocates that the means of production, distribution, and exchange should be owned or regulated by the community as a whole is called socialist or socialism. And so students, let's turn to the next page. So students, on the page 56 we saw preamble is the core and important part of constitution. Indian constitution begins with preamble. And the words written in the preamble highlight the soul of the constitution. Then we saw about the what is preamble we saw, and I told you to turn the page. Now let's see over here. The words are written, and so pay attention. The preamble remained unchanged till 1976. In 1976, the words socialist, secular, unity and integrity of the nation were added. Till 1976, there were no changes in the preamble, but later on they added some words. And which were the words, students? Look there. Socialist, secular, unity and integrity. These four words were added. These four words were added into the preamble. Then the preamble verbalized the fundamental objectives of the constitution, aims, ideas and principles. Therefore, the preamble straight away gives a clear insight of the rule of welfare. The preamble reflects constitution framers' psyche. Constitution framers' psyche. Those who have framed the constitution, their psyche, their mind, their body, their what was going on and all, it is being reflected. It tells about them in the preamble. Now, what is the importance of preamble? Be with me, students. What is the importance of the preamble? Now, the preamble as the soul, the preamble as the soul, the preamble as the soul of the constitution is also an important necessity. Make a bracket to this. To understand the framing of any law or its interpretation, preamble gives proper guidance. So students, if you want to know what it is and to get, preamble will be a guide to you. It will give you what is it proper. And so, to understand the policy behind the framing of any law, preamble plays an important role. The preamble is a useful tool to avoid the trouble in the interpretation of the constitution. There are some people who do not know to interpret, do not know to explain the constitution properly. They may take it wrongly. They may give you the wrong idea. But preamble as a guide, it will help to give the proper idea. Then, when any ambiguity or obscure details in the law arises, preamble helps in understanding and interpreting the law. Thus, preamble serves as a compass to understand to the provisions of constitutional law. Underline that. Thus, preamble serves as a compass to understand the provisions of constitutional law. Now, students, when you are going somewhere out, you do not know to which directions to go. You put on in the mobile, you put the compass to show you the ideas. Okay, to show you the proper direction. And so preamble is just like a compass. It will direct you, it will guide you. ambiguity and obscure. What is the meaning of ambiguity and obscure? So student, ambiguity and obscure means unclear, the vague details. When the problem, when you are not clear about certain things, it is preamble that will help you to get the proper idea. Then preamble is nation's unity, integrity, and is the standard crest of brotherhood among citizens who are having noble sentiments and ideals. Preamble is backed by high ideals and goals. Preamble is backed by high ideals and goals. Students, where do you get to hear this high ideals word? When you sing your school anthem, you have royal shall we be to your high ideals. And so high ideal, you try to be perfect. It cannot become a reality, but we try to be high, try to be give to practice those high ideals, the goals. We may achieve, we may not achieve, but we try to. And so preamble is what? Is nation's unity, integrity, and is the standard crest of brotherhood among citizens. Students, what is that fraternity? We saw it also in the preamble. Fraternity, as in Hindi, you call it as Bhai Chaar. Okay? Bhai Chaar. You are supposed to live as brothers and sisters, and we do live in our country. We try to help one another. So, let's get the idea clear. Now, pillars of the preamble. Which are the pillars of the preamble? Okay, the words inscribed in the preamble are, which are the words? We the people of India. We the people of India. We, you and I and all are, those who are Indians are included over here. Sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic, republic, justice, liberty, fraternity and equality. All these words are in the capital letters. What are they? Here we will study the following three main pillars of the preamble. Let's see which are the three main pillars of the preamble. Today we shall see about one, and we shall study the other two tomorrow. Today we are not able to finish all this, but we will take today one, and that is about the democracy. Now let's see what is a democracy. So be with me, students. The ultimate sovereignty of power is with the people according to Indian Constitution. According to Indian Constitution, the power is in the hand of the people. Students, you have learned what is the definition of the democracy. What do you mean by democracy? You have studied this when you were in 6th standard, 7th standard. Okay? And many of you used to say, by the people, of the people, for the people. And what is that? The government. A democracy. And so students, over here, what is that? The power is in the, according to the, power is with the people according to Indian Constitution. There is no particular regime of any one particular person. Instead, it is with the people. It is not a single person, but it is the union of people. It's a group of people. They come together, they elect the leader. They means now who, students? We all. We the people of India, as we saw. Okay? Now the democracy. Democracy, the word is derived from Greek word demos, means people, and kratos means power. So what is the meaning of demos means? Demos means people, and kratos means power. Now, country's power is not within a group of people. Instead, it is with the people of the country. Students, you should get the idea very clear. It is not with a particular group, but instead it is within the people of the country. It lies in the hand of the people of the country and not a particular group of people. And so, democratic state administration is such an arrangement in which there is equal justice for people to social, economical and political, and having equal rights of participation. Students, equal right of participations. As I told, equality. And what equality? What type of justice we want to give? Social, political justice. Okay? And so over here, we will get it still clearer. The idea will become clear as you read ahead. Now, in democratic In democratic India, people elect their leaders through their choice by casting vote to represent those leaders in the parliament, and therefore assuming the post of prime minister and his cabinet. Students, you know, during the election time, different leaders have a campaign. They say that vote for so and so. They try to propagate it. But students, they try to make the propaganda of it. And we also use a head and we see whom we want to vote. Can everyone vote? Can the children vote? No. Unless and until you are 18, you have no power to vote. And so students, it is what? It is through their choice. Whose choice? It is the choice of the people. We cast the vote. You go for voting. You have seen your mommy, daddy going for voting. And then only we select or elect our leaders. Executives do not have absolute power. They are given specific time limit. Similarly, the voters elect state and local level government. Underline that. Similarly, voters elect state and local level government. Okay? So we elect it. Hence, democracy means by the people, for the people, and of the people. Underline and make the bracket this sentence. Hence, what? Democracy means by the people, for the people, and of the people. Make a bracket. Then, cabinet consists members of parliament. Cabinet of ministers is responsible to the parliament. Cabinet of ministers is responsible. The members coming together, they are responsible. Their cabinet of ministers is responsible to the parliament. About the parliament also we are going to study later on in the next chapters. You will have your 10th chapter. Chapter number 10. Any citizen of India who possesses required constitutional eligibility can contest the election. Any citizen of India. Students, there are some criterias, age limit and all, which we are going to study in the next chapter. Ministerial positions are not acquired hereditary. It is not that, suppose your father is a leader, great leader, and so it is necessary that you should become and your children should become. No. It is the people who elect, who has the capacity, who has the abilities, and so we elect the leader. It is not by hereditary. Each elected government has 5 years of tenure. They can have that power in their hand for 5 years. Underline that. This government works under the principles of constitution, and therefore it is known as responsible government. They are responsible for it, and therefore it is called as the responsible government. The democratic government is based on liberty, equality, and feeling of fraternity, and continuously work to achieve these goals. So government is based on liberty, equality, and feeling of fraternity, underline that. And so we try to achieve that. The constitution, come to the next page, students. The constitution disseminates the power to people to cast their vote according to their free will, and thereby instills confidence in the constitution. So students, see, we are not supposed to force anyone to vote so and so. They are free to vote, and constitution helps us. But then, the constitution of democratic India renders fundamental rights, principles for political directions, parliament, members of assembly, independent and impartial justice, and election commission are those provisions which make our country democratic in every means. Make a bracket. These are directive principles, the members, and these what members of the assembly, they make our country as a democratic in every way, every means. Now, you will be asked every year 2 marks question. What do you mean by adult suffrage? So, adult suffrage, students be with me. Adult suffrage means the citizens above 18 years of age can cast his or her vote to one's choice of leaders without discriminating caste, creed, religion, language, gender, education, and income or birthplace. But it is essential that the citizens are enlisted in the electoral list. So, now students here. What do you mean by the adult suffrage? The person, the citizen above 18 has the right, person has to be above 18 years. Okay, 18 years of age. And then he should be having a choice to vote. His name should be there in the electoral list. But he also has the right to choose his own leader. But how? Without any caste. He shouldn't see that he belongs to this caste. He doesn't belong to my caste or my religion or doesn't speak my language or she is a female or he is a male. No, students, we shouldn't be seeing this all. Without all this. But it is essential that the citizens are enlisted in the electoral list. The name has to be there. So every year 2 marks question is asked. What do you mean by adult suffrage? Also, the preamble, whatever we studied about preamble, its importance, which are the pillars, which 3 are the pillars, that is the democracy. Then we are going to study about socialist and secularism. So students, these are the 3 main pillars. We will be studying in detail. Today we saw about the democracy. And now, I'm just going to stop the class over here. I will send you the board work. You are supposed to do it in your FAIR notebook. Write the question answers and also the important points to remember. Look at the board, students. I just written about preamble. It remained unchanged till 1976. And the preamble reflects the constitution framers psyche. There are 5 questions for you. Please do study at home. Have a good day. See you tomorrow.